Welcome to BioGlobe. If you like this channel, please like, share and subscribe. Today we are going to discuss the bacteria Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Myself Mohammad Jaseel A, Assistant Professor of Microbiology, Marcus Arts and Science College, Adavanad. Morphology. Pseudomonas aeruginosa is a slender gram-negative bacillus. Size is about 1.5 to 3 micrometer in length and 0.5 micrometer in breadth. They are arranged in single or in pairs or in short chains. They are actually motile organism by one or two polar flagella. They are non-sporing and non-capsulated organisms, but many strains have mucoid slime layer. Cultural characters. They are obligate aerobe. The optimum pH is about 7.2 to 7.4 and optimum temperature is about 37 degrees Celsius. It can grow on ordinary media like nutrient agar, blood agar, etc. What are the media and colony characters? Pseudomonas produce 6 distinct colony types. First one, large irregular colonies surrounded by serrated skirt of growth. Serrated skirt type colonies means sharp edged colonies. Then second one, small smooth like coliforms type colonies. Then small rough colonies and small rugose colonies. Rugose means wrinkled colonies. Then mucoid colonies and dwarf, that is smallest colonies. On nutrient agar, colonies are to be large, 2 to 3 millimeter in diameter, irregular, oval around long axis, convex, smooth, opaque, and emit characteristics fruity odor or earthy smell. That is an important property, possessing fruity odor or earthy smell. This is due to the production of O-aminoacetophenone from tryptophan. Earthy smell is due to the production of O-aminoacetophenone from tryptophan and possess metallic sheen along with bluish green diffusible pigment. Mucoid colonies are especially observed when isolate is from patients of cystic fibrosis. Cystic fibrosis means an hereditary disease affecting the exocrine glands. It causes the production of abnormally thick mucus, leading to the blockage of pancreatic ducts, intestine and bronchi, and often resulting in respiratory tract infection. This is the colony of Pseudomonas aeruginosa on nutrient agar, and this is a gram stain picture of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. On blood agar, they are forming hemolytic colonies. Then on Meckonghi's agar, they are non-lactose fermenters, or they produce non-lactose fermenting colonies, that is colorless colonies. Pigments produced by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. This is very, very important. What are the main types of pigments produced by Pseudomonas aeruginosa? First one, pyocyanin. It is a bluish green diffusible phenazin pigment soluble in water and chloroform. It is an identifying feature of Pseudomonas aeruginosa as it is not produced by any other species. It inhibits growth of many other bacteria, so contributes to Pseudomonas aeruginosa emerging dominant bacteria in mixed infections. This is the colony of pyocyanin pigment. Then fluorescein, second pigment is known as fluorescein. It's also called pyoverdin. It's a greenish yellow pigment, soluble in water but not in chloroform. It may be produced by many species. It gives yellowish tinge to culture, which can be better observed when the plate is examined under UV light, that is UV illuminator. In old culture, it may be oxidized to yellowish brown pigment. This is the picture of fluorescein pigment of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Then pyorubin is the next pigment produced by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It is a bright red phenazin pigment, soluble in water and insoluble in chloroform. Then last pigment, pyomelanin. It's a brown-black pigment. It's a brown-black pigment that is known as pyomelanin. Then what are the biochemical reactions of Pseudomonas aeruginosa? It's a non-fermenter organism. Their metabolism is oxidative type. It has to be tested on oxidation fermentation media as acid produced by oxidative pathway is less than that produced by fermentation. It utilizes only glucose oxidatively. Now what are the IMVC result? Indole negative, methyl red negative, Waagers Proskauer negative, citrate to be positive, and H2S is negative. All strains give prompt oxidase positive reaction within 13 seconds. Reduce nitrate to nitrate and catalyze positive and gelatinase negative. Resistant or sensitive factors of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Pseudomonas aeruginosa survives well in wet environment and is susceptible to heat. It is resistant to common disinfectants and antiseptics and can grow in some disinfectant solutions such as iodine, hexachlorophane, soap solution, quaternary ammonium compounds. Therefore, cetrimide can be incorporated in selective media. Quaternary ammonium compounds means it's a cationic surface active agent with bactericidal and virusal activity and a good detergent also. It has considerable natural resistance to many antibiotics. What are the antigens of Pseudomonas aeruginosa? Mainly two types of antigen, O antigen and H antigen. In the case of O antigen, mainly 19 group specific O antigen as there. On this basis, it can be divided into 27 serotypes. Serotype 6 and 11 predominate in clinical specimens, and type 11 is mainly responsible for most hospital acquired infections. Type 11 is serotypes is a causative indicator of hospital acquired infections. H antigen, it has two heat labile H antigens. Virulence factors, that is toxins and enzymes produced by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Extracellular products. Pyocyanin inhibits mitochondrial enzymes in tissue and causes disruption and cessation of ciliary beat on ciliated nasal epithelium, which favors colonization by organisms by avoiding its clearance from respiratory mucosa by host defenses. Cessation means ending. Extracellular enzymes and hemolysins. It produces proteases, general protease, alkaline protease, and elastase. Hemolysin and lipases, which help in formation of local lesions. That is, proteases and hemolysin and lipases help in formation of local lesion. Then elastase. It digests elastin of arterial wall, leading to destructive vascular lesions along with hemorrhage. It also inactivates some complement components. It causes tissue necrosis along with alkaline protease. General protease is a collagenase that hydrolyzes collagen. Proteases, they aid in spread of organism in tissue. Hemolysin, they are mildly toxic, heat labile, phospholipase C, and cause redness and induration on intradermal injection. Lipases, they degrade a variety of fats. Exotoxin, it produces two exotoxins A and S. A is polypeptide that inhibits protein synthesis. Endotoxin, it is a lipopolysaccharide, exhibits all properties of enterobacterial lipopolysaccharide including pyrogenic action and Schwarzman reaction. Pyrogenic action means producing heat. Schwarzman reaction means the reaction of endotoxin creating thrombosis in the affected tissue. That is a Schwarzman reaction. Then pathogenicity, that is the disease causing ability of Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Pseudomonas aeruginosa can cause infection in community or outside the hospital as well as hospital acquired infection. That is known as nosocomial infection. Most common infection outside hospital is suppurative otitis. Its ability to persist in moist environment of wards, bedroom, kitchen, equipment like respirator, scopes, articles like bedpan, medicine such as eye or ear drops, lotions, ointment, distilled water and fluor favors its role in hospital acquired infection, such as infections of wound, bed sores. Bed sores means injuries to skin and underlying tissue resulting from prolonged pressure on skin. Then eye infections, urinary tract infections following catheterization, acute purulent meningitis following lumbar puncture or cranial injury, necrotizing pneumonia following colonization of ventilators in debilitated persons. Necrotizing pneumonia means uncommon severe complication of pneumonia characterized by destruction of underlying lung parenchyma resulting in multiple small thin walled cavities and often accompanied by empyema and bronchopleural fistulae. Debilitated patients means weak patients. Then septic arthritis and endocarditis in drug addicts. Septic arthritis means painful infection of joints. Endocarditis means inflammation of endocardium or inflammation or heart valve. Septicemia and endocarditis in debilitated persons. Infection of nail bud following excessive exposure to detergents and water. Infection of nail bud due to excessive exposure to detergent and water. Infantile diarrhea and sepsis. Shanghai fever or a self-limited fever. It can cause acute necrotizing vasculitis leading to hemorrhagic infarction of skin and internal organs. Acute necrotizing vasculitis means, what is the meaning of vasculitis? Inflammation of blood vessel that causes changes in the blood vessel wall. Vasculitis can cause vessel walls to thick and narrow. Hemorrhagic infarction means ischemic infarction, an area of bleeding exists within necrosing cerebral tissue. It can cause acute necrotizing vasculitis leading to hemorrhagic infarction. Then laboratory diagnosis. Specimen. What are the specimen to be collected? Pus, wound swab, urine, sputum, blood, etc. depending on the site involved. Collection. Sample should be collected in sterile containers by using appropriate procedures. Transport. Sample should be immediately transported to the microbiology laboratory. Processing of specimen by using microscopy. Wet preparation of liquid specimen shows pus cells along with motile bacilli. Gram staining forming shows pus cells along with gram negative bacilli. Non-capsulated, non-sporing organism arranged single or in short chains. Culture. Specimen is plated on blood agar and McConkie's agar. On blood agar, they are forming large, irregular, smooth, opaque colonies with fruity odor, bluish-green pigment and forming hemolysis. On McConkie's agar, they are forming non-lactose fermenting colonies. On cetrimide agar, it is required especially for isolation of pseudomonas from stool or wound swab where mixed flora is present. Mixed flora is always present in the case of stool or wound swab. We can use cetrimide agar for the culturing. Then biochemical reactions, they attack glucose oxidatively, oxidase positive and citrate positive. Biochemical reactions are detailed discussion is there in previous slides. Then antibiotic sensitivity testing. It is performed by Kirby-Boyer disc diffusion method using amikacin, carbenicillin, azelocillin, tricarcillin, cefotaxime, ceftazidime, gentamicin, tobramycin, ciprofloxacin, another quinolone and cefoperazone antibiotics. Then control. Prevention of Pseudomonas aeruginosa cross-infection in hospitals requires constant vigilance and strict attention to asepsis. What are the treatment? Can be treated with a combination of an anti-Pseudomonas beta-lactam and aminoglycoside. The beta-lactam includes penicillin or cephalosporin. And aminoglycoside, carbapenem, example imipenem or meropenem, with anti-pseudomonal quinolones may be used in conjunction with aminoglycosides. These are all about Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe.